What's up guys, this is Oh Boy Tuts, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to use the autotune function that comes with Logic Pro. Not the Antares autotune or anything, just the stock autotune. Because a lot of people ask me, how do I get it sounding so good and clean? And it's not really too difficult. You know, the trick is just finding the right key and setting the response accordingly. So this is the vocal without autotune.
Started out the day planning a night out on the town, making sure that she make all of her rounds. Now, as soon as she hit a sound, she gets her head in the clouds into herself, but got it figured all out.
Okay, so the vocal alone does sound pretty good, like singing wise, with no autotune. And that is another step. You do have to be a decent singer for autotune to sound good, but not saying you have to be like, you know, Adele or anyone for autotune to sound good. You just need to hit the right notes that are within the scale, and then autotune will sound perfect for you. But let's show you how to get it working. So you just go to pitch correction, and some people just keep it on chromatic and they're wondering why it sounds bad. That's because you're not in the right key of the song. So if you're working with a producer and they already know the key of the song, then that's perfect, and you just set, let's say the producer says the song is C major, you just click major scale and then click C major, and then you would drag the response all the way down, and then you're good. But let's say you don't know the key of the song and you don't know how to find the key of the song. You could do what I do sometimes, and I basically either click major or minor, natural minor scale, depending on how the song sounds. If the song sounds more happy and upbeat, then you're gonna click major scale. If it sounds more sad and dark, then click natural minor scale. So this one is more happy sounding, so I'm going to stick with major scale. And then you would drag the response all the way down to zero. And now, basically what you're doing is you're going to switch the root note up until the vocal starts sounding clean and good. And that's basically how you find it. So let's take a listen.
Started out the day planning a night out on the town, making sure that she make all of her rounds now.
Okay, so it sounded pretty good up until this last statement right here, which kind of wobbled too much.
All of her rounds.
So let's go to the next note, C sharp.
Started out the day planning.
No way. So I'm just going to keep going down until I find one that sounds good.
Started out the day planning a night out on the town, making sure that she make all of her rounds.
Nope.
Started out the day planning a night out on the town, making sure that she make all of her rounds. Now, as soon as she hit a sound, she gets her head in the clouds into herself, but got it figured all out.
There we go. That sounds clean to me. And so it's D sharp major. And that's, sometimes it's that quick, sometimes it's a little bit harder, you gotta switch up the scale, but sometimes it's that easy, and that's basically how you find the key of the song. And then you just apply that to all your other vocal tracks, and it should come out sounding clean.
Started out the day planning a night out on the town, making sure that she make all of her rounds. Now, as soon as she hit a sound, she gets her head in the clouds into herself, but got it figured all out.
Sounds good to me. And if you want, you can mess with the response time. If you go higher up, it's going to be less autotune, and if you go lower, it's going to be more autotune. So that's basically how you use autotune and find the root note of the song. Thanks for watching. Peace out.